वेलकम फ्रेंड्स इन साइंस लेक्चर 5 लेसन 3 मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ मेटल्स. दैट इज फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट मिनरल्स व्हाट आर कॉल्ड एज मिनरल्स. तो इन मिनरल्स द एलिमेंट्स आर कंपाउंड्स विच अकर नेचुरली इन द अर्थ क्रस्ट. दे आर अकरिंग नेचुरली इन द अर्थ क्रस्ट इन आर नोन एज मिनरल्स लाइक एलम. एलम फॉर्मूला इज K2SO4 Al2SO4 thrice dot 24H2O are found in free state. In the same way, gold is totally found in free state in an element condition. They are all called as minerals obtained from the earth crust. Secondly, what is called as an ore. So ore are the minerals. These are the minerals which are metals. Their target is the metals. So these ores are minerals from which the metals can be extracted. So the main target for extraction is metals. Ores are, minerals are many available, but we don't have any target for us extracting everyone. So here the target is that we need to extract, suppose aluminium. So the bauxite here is an ore. So Al2O3.2H2O, in which our target is to extract aluminium from it, aluminium ore. This is called as an aluminium ore. Same way copper pyrite, CuFeS2. So here our target is to obtain the copper here. So this is called as an copper ore. Fine. The next is gangue. Gangue is an unwanted impurity like sand, rocky minerals, earth particles, limestone, mica, etc. in an ore are called as an gangue. So here the gangue is an unwanted impurity like sand, rocky materials, earth particles, limestone and mica. So they are not, we are not having any target to extract this kind of material. So our main target is to extract the minerals, fine, from the ore. So this is gangue. Another form we say it is a waste material for us. Now extraction of metals from the ore, our targets are generally that metals found in free state are, that is directly we can obtain from the earth crust, are gold, platinum, silver, copper. They are found in free state. But silver and copper are generally not found also every time in free state. They are found in sulfides and oxide forms. Now highly reactive elements like potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium and aluminium are never found in free state. That means they are never found in free state, and these elements are supposed to be extracted. Now moderate, that is lower than that category, moderate reactive elements like zinc, iron, lead, etc. are also found in free state. That means they are not found in free state. That means need to be extracted by the processes and we can recover them from the earth crust. Generally ores formed and are in three basic forms. They are metal oxides, metal sulfides and metal carbonates. So these are the three basic forms only. Sometimes in the form of hydroxide also we obtain, sometimes in form of phosphates, sometimes in form of sulfates and chlorides. But generally we obtain in the form of metal oxide, metal sulfides and metal carbonates. These are the basic forms which are available on the earth crust. So the next our, that how the metals should be extracted. First of all, we'll see the series and try to understand it out about the series only. Now, as we have done this before also, and I told you to write down this series and learn this reactivity series, you may see from this series around, you may see the potassium is having the highest reactivity. So these are very high reactive elements like sodium, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium and aluminium. They are not found at all in free state and cannot be reduced by carbon also. That means carbon cannot free them from the nature. So we cannot have that carbon can displace them. So they are obtained by another method called as an electrolysis. In the same way, lower than carbon atoms, carbon, that is iron, zinc, iron, lead, copper and mercury, these are, I could say, they are moderate reacting elements and can be reduced by carbon. So they can be reduced by carbon and obtained up till here. Right, so from zinc to iron, that is zinc, iron, lead, copper and mercury can be free by carbon in the form of an coke. So they are moderate reacting elements, and they are very less reactive elements come silver, gold and platinum. So they are generally found in free state only, so they can be extracted. Now we'll learn how the metals are extracted with low this is low reactivity. Now very less reactivity forms oxide of sulfides in nature. We say cinnabar. Cinnabar is an ore of mercury sulfide. Fine. So mercury sulfide reacting with oxygen and the heat, they are heated in the presence of oxygen. So we say the sulfur dioxide gas is evaporated and forms into mercury oxide. So our very target is to form into form of an oxide. So this is the key target, to form of an in the form of an oxide. After these oxides are heated, so we have the free mercury directly. That means we don't have to do any procedure in this. We have to just heat these kind of elements which are having in the low reactivity series. The same way with respect to copper sulfide, if you see, copper sulfide also in the presence of oxygen heated forms copper oxide from sulfide, and sulfur dioxide gas is liberated. In the same way, this oxide furthermore treated with copper sulfide becomes copper, and sulfur dioxide gas is evaporated. So we have free copper here. Fine. So we have free copper available. So we have free mercury also and free copper also in this simple reaction. So these are least reactive elements, and from the due to this least reactivity, they can be directly obtained. Now, which are moderately reacting elements, we have seen that metals like zinc, iron, lead, copper, and etc. are moderate reacting elements. They cannot be obtained directly by heating every time, maybe in the form of an oxide or carbonate. So we will see the procedure how we do it. Now there are three types, as we have learned, in the form of an oxide, sulfides and carbonates. So they can be converted by the reduction process. Now first we will take as a process of reduction process as roasting. Now in case of an roasting, if you see, the sulfides are converted into oxides by heating strongly in the presence of excess air. Here the excess air is supposed to be used. So we can say that zinc sulfide here as an example, in the presence of oxygen is heated highly with an excess amount of oxygen, turns to zinc oxide and sulfur dioxide gas is liberated. In the same case here, by of the reduction, thus next is the carbonate ores. That is, procedure is called as an calcination. So the carbonate ores are strongly heated, but in limited air. Here the air is quite limited. So if you see, zinc carbonate is heated with a limited amount of air, that is oxygen. So zinc oxide and carbon dioxide is formed. Fine. So zinc oxide and carbon dioxide is formed. The third is reduction process. In the reduction process, if you see, the reduction process, we have two things. First, the reduction by carbon. Now in case of a reduction by carbon, only those metals or oxide metal oxides are reduced, that is been reduced by roasting and calcination. The same way these oxides that are formed, like zinc oxide is formed in both the case of carbonates and sulfides by roasting and calcination, these oxygen need to be cleared. So what we do, we heat with carbon, that is coke. So we heat in the presence of carbon, that is coke, and is heated strongly. So what is formed is zinc, and that means oxygen is taken by carbon and turns to carbon monoxide, or maybe sometimes in the next way is an carbon dioxide. So this carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide is a chain reaction, and the zinc is been cleared out. So every time we have a free zinc available. This can be done by the highly reactive elements also, that is a displacement reaction. The elements like sodium, calcium, aluminum are highly reactive compared to this moderate reacting elements. So you see one reaction here I have written, that is manganese oxide. Here in manganese oxide case, the manganese lower compared to that of an aluminum is displaced and forms magnesium, and aluminum oxide is formed. So manganese is free in the liquid state because it is an highly heat reaction, that is an exothermic reaction. This reaction is called as a thermite reaction. You may learn this also because it is important as an exam point of view. Iron oxide in the presence of aluminum is slightly initially heated, and after that this reaction turns to a chain reaction, and iron is melted out in a very high amount, and with an excess amount of heat is liberated and aluminum oxide is formed. So this is a kind of a displacement reaction which happens, and this is an exothermic reaction. Okay, extraction of metals towards top of the reacting series. These metals are potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminum, etc. They cannot be reduced by any other metal. So we have to take another procedure, that is done by electrolytic reduction process. In this electrolytic reduction process, first they are melted and then by melted. First of all, the procedure is that need to be melted. And by electrolysis method, that is metals forms cations and anions by passing electric current in a high amount according to the requirement, we see that the metals, that is their cathodes, cations, are obtained at cathode. Cathode is a negative electrode. And non-metals like NaCl, if you see, we will see non-metals, that is called as an anions. Non-metals are anions, that is negative ions, are obtained at anode. Anode is a positive electrode. So at negative electrode you have positive ions, and at negative electrode you have, sorry, at negative electrode you have positive ions, and at positive electrode you have negative ions. That is, so here taking one example, cathode. At cathode, which is a negative ion, you see that negative ion has electrons. So Na plus getting one electron turns to sodium as a metal ion, and at anode you see that Cl minus, which is already anion, takes, liberates one electron and turns to Cl2, that is turns to a gas and gets liberated. Fine. Okay, so thank you for this particular video. I hope so you must have understood.